In this video, we will take a general look at the standard model of particle physics. The underlying framework of this theory is quantum field theory, and it's one of the best tested and most successful theories in modern physics. It is the best generally accepted theory that can describe most of the phenomena of the universe. You might ask, what is the standard model? And the answer is not straightforward. Most people know the standard model as the table of all fundamental particles, and this is part of it. From a mathematical point of view, it is a special gauge group, and this we will discuss in a separate video. From a physics point of view, it is a collection of quantum field theories that explain fundamental physics and forces. The aim of this video is to introduce the viewer to the general content of the standard model, and then one can break down the different parts in separate videos. To understand the different particles in the standard model, we must start with spin numbers. This is possibly the single most important property of a particle. We have talked about spin in quantum mechanics, and it is no less important when talking about the standard model. The spin number defines some basic properties of the different particles. The standard model is made from three types of particles, those particles with three different spin numbers. Recall that we can divide particles into two spin categories. There are particles with integer spin like 0, 1 and 2, and these particles are called bosons. Then we have particles with half integer spins, like a half and 3/2. These particles are called fermions. The standard model is made of spin 0, spin half and spin 1 particles. The spin number is related to the math describing the particle. Spin 0 particles are scalar bosons. Spin half particles are fermions, more specifically spinners. And spin 1 particles are vector bosons. These spin numbers are important in understanding how the standard model is organized, and we will see that fermions are what make up matter and bosons make up the forces and the fundamental mass of particles. The standard model has many components. One of its components is the vector bosons. These play a very important role. It is these bosons which are the force carriers of the three different fundamental interactions: the electromagnetic force, the weak force, and the strong force. The boson which carries the electromagnetic force we all know very well. It is called the photon. This is a massless particle, and as we know, it therefore travels at the speed of light, which is also obvious since it is light. We also have three other particles called the W-, W+, and the Z bosons. These three bosons carry the weak force, and they're all massive. Finally, we have the gluons, which carry the strong force, and there are actually 8 of them, and they are all a bit different. These particles are also massless, just like the photon, but we will go into more detail about that later. You might notice that I'm only talking about three fundamental forces. So what about gravity? As we discussed in a video about general relativity, we don't have a fundamental theory of gravity. Naturally, this is one of the main limitations of the standard model, as it doesn't include gravity. We also have another boson, which is not a vector boson. It is the famous scalar boson called the Higgs boson. The governing equation of the Higgs field is very similar to that of the Klein-Gordon equation, since it's a scalar field. The Higgs particle was first postulated back in the 1960s to resolve a core problem in the development of the standard model. The Lagrangian of the standard model has a special symmetry called gauge invariance. In short, this symmetry doesn't allow you to write mass terms in the Lagrangian, like we did with the scalar field theory in the introduction video. To resolve this problem, the Higgs particle and the so-called Higgs mechanism was introduced to give fundamental mass to particles. The details are rather complicated, and we will cover them in a separate video. This Higgs particle was discovered in 2012 at the LHC at CERN in Switzerland, more than 40 years after it was predicted from theory. Needless to say, this was a huge success in the world of particle physics. If we write the Lagrangian of the standard model, we see that there are no mass terms with m, but instead some terms with phi, which we recognize as the scalar Higgs field, and this leads to the mass of the particles. This equation is rather complicated, and we will look at this in detail later. But now you have seen the short version of the standard model Lagrangian, and that the Higgs field is there. Having covered all the bosons, we can move on to fermions. These we can split into two subcategories, called leptons and quarks. Both these particles are spin half. Let us start with discussing the leptons. In the standard model, we have what we call three generations of fermions. This is because we see that many particles are similar in their properties, but their mass is different. If we look at the first generation, we have the electron and the electron neutrino. The electron we know from the atom, and the electrons themselves are fundamental particles. Electrons have a negative charge, and they are rather lightweight, weighing around 0.511 megaelectronvolt. The electron is part of the first generation of fermions. Its bigger brother from the second and third generation are called the muon and tau particle. These particles are much heavier, and the muon has a mass of 106 megaelectronvolt, and the tau particle is even heavier, at 1776 megaelectronvolt. As mentioned before, we also have the neutrinos. These particles are almost massless, and it's still not clear what their masses are and how to correctly describe these particles. There are three types called the electron neutrino, the muon neutrino, and the tau neutrino. These six particles are all fermions and they are called leptons. Now we have discussed everything except quarks, and these are also fermions. These particles are different than leptons because they don't exist on their own, and they must always be together with other quarks forming composite particles. An example is the proton. The proton, which we find in all atoms, is made from three quarks. More precisely, the proton is made from two up quarks and a down quark. In a similar way, the neutron is made from two down quarks and an up quark. The reason for why quarks are not free and must be together in composite particles is related to the strong force, which we will discuss later. But there are many other ways that quarks can form composite particles. The up and down quark belong to the first generation, but like with the leptons, there are three generations. So from the second generation, we have the charm and strange quarks, which are heavier than the up and down quark. In the third generation, we have the heaviest quarks called the top and bottom quark. Thus, we again have six quarks, just like we have six leptons. You might ask why we have three generations of fermions, and the honest answer is that we don't know. Just like we don't know why the standard model has this mathematical structure which it has. Initially, we only knew particles of the first generation, but experiments in the middle of the 20th century found evidence of the strange quark, and later the charm quark. Eventually, we also found the bottom quark, and after that, it was no surprise that we also later discovered the top quark. It is currently not possible to rule out a fourth generation, but there are many constraints and a lot of evidence that suggest that there are in fact only three generations. We have now introduced all the forces and particles of the standard model, and many people have probably seen this organized table with all the particles, and this is often what people associate with the standard model. But it ignores a lot of the complex theories describing all of the underlying physics where these particles are involved. The table of the standard model can also be considered like the periodic table for particle physicists. On the left hand side you have the fermions with quarks above the leptons. Then to the right of that you have the vector bosons, which are the force carriers. And finally on the right you have the Higgs boson, which is important in relation to the fundamental masses of the massive particles of the standard model. At this point, many of you might be asking, why don't we just invent a new particle like the graviton, which would be the force carrier of gravity? This appears to be the obvious solution since it works for the other forces. The problem is that it doesn't work, and there are several reasons for that. But that's a rather advanced discussion. The fact is that we don't even know if quantum gravity is even a thing, and thus we don't know if a quantum field theory for gravity is necessary. While the standard model accounts for most of the physics we know, it still has limits. This doesn't take away from the fact that it has been extremely successful and its predictions has been very accurate and the theoretical results fits with experiments. But before ending the video, we can just mention a few issues. The biggest problem with the standard model is that it doesn't include gravity. The nature of the neutrinos is not entirely clear, and there's still the unanswered question of dark matter and dark energy. There are also many technical issues, like the hierarchy problem, the strong CP problem, the question of why three generations, and this peculiar mathematical structure. These questions may have an answer, and many physicists are working on solving them. Solutions involve new extensions to the standard model, and maybe we need to develop some grand unified theory or theory of everything to resolve these limitations of the standard model. I think it is clear now that we have much to discuss in future videos, so please comment on what you like and what you would like to see in the future. Feel free to like and subscribe so you don't miss out on the next video. If you want to support me, please check the link below and buy me a coffee. As always, stay tuned for more videos.